Tell me what you eat, and I will tell you what you are. Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Sivapriya, and I'm going to give an eye-opener about functional foods in health and disease prevention. Food and diet play a crucial role in maintaining health and in the prevention of diseases. The tenet, let food be thy medicine and medicine be thy food, was embraced 2,500 years ago by Hippocrates, the father of medicine. Thomas Alva Edison said, the doctor of future will no longer treat the human frame with drugs, but rather will cure and prevent disease with nutrition. However, these ideologies, food as medicine, fell into obscurity in the 19th century with the arrival of modern drug therapy. Let us see an abstract. The menace of nutritional imbalance arising from change in behavior of humans with respect to eating habits poses threat to human health and hence requires swift revitalization. Have you ever thought how this revitalization can be done? These revitalization can be done to some extent by functional foods. As health costs and average life expectancy rises, the public has sought ways to become healthier and develop higher qualities of life. The concept of functional food developed as a convenient an inexpensive solution to chronic health problems and has become influential in numerous branches of science and policies. In the early 20th century, nutrition science was concerned only on eradicating deficiency diseases, malnutrition, and supporting body growth by identifying rich sources of food and determining the recommended intakes of vitamins and minerals. By the end of the 20th century, although basic nutritional adequacy remained important, the economic growth enjoyed by numerous countries after the First World War resulted in a prompt increase in lifestyle-related diseases such as diabetes, atherosclerosis, osteoporosis, cancer, and so on in the old-age population. Although food pyramid and healthy eating plates serve as guides for them, people were not satisfied with these tools, and a growing number of consumers opted for traditional medicines to perk up their health status and to protect them against degenerative diseases. This led to the claim for food commodities with superior health characteristics. Scientists also began to identify physiologically active components in food from both plants and animals, known as phytochemicals and zoochemicals respectively, that could reduce risk of a variety of chronic diseases. These events, coupled with an aging, health-conscious population, new evidence-based science linking diet to disease and disease prevention, changes in food regulations, numerous technological advances, and a marketplace ripe for the introduction of health-promoting products, provided an unprecedented opportunity for the development of functional foods. Now, what is a functional food? Let us see about the various definitions and the concept behind functional food. Functional foods may be defined as any food that has a positive impact on individual's health, physical performance, or state of mind in addition to its nutritious value. Other additional considerations have been proposed to define a functional food, including three additional conditions in particular. Number one, it should be a food. It should be derived from natural ingredients. It should not be a capsule, tablet, or powder. Number two is, it can and should be consumed as a part of healthy diet, like for example, soya kurma, green leafy kutu, puriyal, etc. Then it has a particular function when eaten, serving to regulate a particular body process, such as enhancement of biological defense mechanisms, prevention of specific diseases, recovery from specific diseases, control of physical and mental disorders, slowing of the aging process. Hence, a functional food should do all these functions perfectly. The functional food have no universally accepted definition, and the concept was first developed in Japan in 1980s. the Japanese government developed food for specified health users, force you to identify conventional foods that positively contribute to physiological systems in the human body from other foods by allowing these foods to have health claims and an approved logo printed on their package. Characteristics of food for specified health users. These are the characteristics of foshu. So when a food has a foshu emblem on the packet, the food should possess all these characters, contribute to health maintenance and enhancement. Scientific evidence for the claimed health benefit. Then clinical and nutritional intake level of the product. That is, the product should possess the clinical and nutritional intake level of the product, and its functional component is to be established. Nutrient constituent of same type of food is not significantly changed. The food is intended to be consumed on a daily basis and not on rare occasions. The product or its functional component is not included in the medical drug license. Hence, it is not a medicine. It is a functional food. It is a food. And next is the definition given by the American Dietetic Association. American Dietetic Association defines functional food as whole foods, fortified, enriched, or enhanced foods. They have a potentially beneficial effect on health when consumed as a part of a varied diet on a regular basis at effective levels. Fortified food means a food that lacks certain nutrients. For example, milk. Milk doesn't have iron. Salt. Salt also doesn't have iron. So it can be fortified to give the nutrient. Enrichment. It is a process in which a particular product may have lost its nutritional property during processing. That is, rice might have lost its nutrient contents while milling. So it can be enriched with vitamins. And enhanced food. Enhanced foods are given for special purposes. So they should have a potentially beneficial effect on health when consumed as a part of diet on a regular basis at effective levels. The European Food Safety Authority defines functional food as a food which beneficially affects one or more targeted functions in the body beyond adequate nutritional effects in a way that is relevant to either an improved state of health and well-being and reduction of risk of diseases. The British Nutrition Foundation defines the term functional food as foods and drinks that are enriched with particular nutrients or substances that have the potential to positively influence health over and above their basic nutritional value. These are the health claims given by the FDA. That is, a product, if a product has got a health claim from FDA, it should possess like calcium and osteoporosis. When you're buying a product, when you're buying a packed milk from supermarket, the product, if it has a health claim on it, what does it mean? Calcium and osteoporosis. Take for example, a packet milk, calcium and osteoporosis. It should mention that regular exercise and a healthy diet with enough calcium helps teens and young adults maintain good bone health and may reduce the risk of osteoporosis. Similarly, if we are buying salt in the market, the packet, if it has been approved by FDA, it should say diets low in sodium may reduce the risk of high blood pressure, a dietary fat and cancer. If, for example, if you are buying olive oil, canola oil in market, the packet, it should have these words: a diet low in fat may reduce risk of some cancers. And these are the examples of the model claims given by the FDA. Next, coming to the term nutraceutical. Nutraceutical is a term coined to describe substances which are not traditionally recognized nutrients, but which have positive physiological effect on human body. They do not easily fall into the legal category of food and drug and often inhabit a gray area between the two. Risk of toxicity or adverse effect of drugs led to consider safer nutraceutical and functional foods approaches for the health development. This resulted in worldwide nutraceutical revolution. Let us now see the health benefits of a nutraceutical. Nutraceuticals have received considerable interest because of the presumed safety and potential nutritional and therapeutic effects. Some popular nutraceuticals include glucosamine, ginseng, echinacea, folic acid, cod liver oil, omega-3X, calcium-enriched orange juices, green tea, etc. Majority of the nutraceuticals are claimed to possess multiple therapeutic benefits, though substantial evidence is lacking for the benefit as well as unwanted effects. The term nutraceutical was coined from the word nutrition and pharmaceutical in 1989 by Stephen D. Fellows. According to him, a nutraceutical is any substance that is a food or a part of food and provides medical or health benefits, including the prevention and treatment of disease. Such products, they may range from isolated nutrients, dietary supplements, and specific diets to genetically engineered designer foods and herbal products. So this is how the nutraceutical is defined. So nutrition supplements are made into pharmaceuticals or a pharma product. Their efficacy as well as the safety, they should be scientifically proved. That will result in a product nutraceutical. So nutritional supplements are made into pharmaceuticals, pharmaceutical products, after proving their safety and efficacy by means of scientific evidences. This is the how nutraceuticals are defined. So this is the concept of nutraceutical: nutrients required for health plus pharmaceutical remedy for sickness. They resulted in the development of nutraceutical as a preventative approach. Nutraceutical offers many benefits. Nutraceuticals, they may increase the health value of our diet, may help us live longer, may help us to avoid particular medical conditions. We may have a psychological benefit from doing something for oneself, may be perceived to be more natural than traditional medicine and less likely to produce unpleasant side effects. They may present food for population with special needs, example, nutrient-dense foods for the elderly. So herbs are used in the production of nutraceuticals. These are examples of some herbs that are used in the production of nutraceuticals. Aloe vera gel, it helps in dilation of capillaries. It has anti-inflammatory and wound healing property. Echinacea, it is an immunostimulant, that is, it boosts our immunity. It helps in the treatment of cold and flu symptoms. Evening primrose oil, dietary supplement of linoleic acid, treatment of atopic eczema. Feverfew, it is useful in the treatment of headache, fever, and menstrual problems. Next is garlic. It is an antibacterial, antifungal, antithrombotic, hypotensive, and anti-inflammatory. Ginger, it is a carminative, helps in digestion, anti-emetic, hologo, and is a positive inotropic. So phytochemicals, what are these phytochemicals? Phytochemicals are biologically active components present in plants. These are also known as secondary metabolites of plants. Plants are largely, phytochemicals are largely metabolized by the same enzymes that metabolize food and drugs. First described and discovered in 1950s by Julius Axelrod, cytochrome P450 are a set of enzymes capable of promoting excretion of xenobiotics through hydroxylation reactions. So this was the first phytochemical found. Phytochemicals could provide health benefits such as they act as substrates for some biochemical reactions. Also, they act as coenzymes for some enzymatic reactions. Also, they are inhibitors of enzymatic reactions. They act as absorbents, sequestrants that bind to and eliminate undesirable constituent in the intestine. Number 5, they act as ligand that agonize or antagonize cell surface or intracellular receptors. They act as scavengers of reactive or toxic chemicals, compounds that enhance the absorption and stability of essential nutrients. They also act as selective growth factors for beneficial gastrointestinal bacteria. They help as fermentation substrates for beneficial oral, gastric, or intestinal bacteria and as selective inhibitors of deleterious intestinal bacteria. Phytochemicals, they are chemicals in plants. They play important role in the growth and development of plants. They protect plants from harmful agents such as insects and microbes, as well as stressful events such as ultraviolet irradiation and extreme temperature. They also attract beneficial birds and insects that promote pollination, germination, and seed dispersal. Phytochemicals also provide health benefits to humans when consumed. They consist of nutrients essential for optimal health, example, protein, carbohydrate, vitamins and minerals, and other chemicals, example, phenolic acids, flavonoids, and other phenolics. Research supporting beneficial roles for phytochemicals again, cancer, coronary heart disease, diabetes, high blood pressure, inflammation, microbial, viral and parasitic infections, psychotic diseases, spasmodic conditions, ulcer, etc. is based on chemical mechanisms using in vitro and cell culture systems, various disease states in animals, and epidemiology of humans. So these are the mechanisms by which a phytochemical works. And these are also the properties of a phytochemical. They possess antioxidant activity by scavenging ROS. They have anti-proliferation and cell cycle arrest. They have apoptosis induction, angiogenesis inhibition, enzyme detoxification, and anti-inflammatory properties. So this is the classification of phytochemicals. The major phytochemicals are carbohydrates, lipids, terpenoids, phenolic acids, alkaloids, and other nitrogen-containing metabolites. So among the phytochemicals, the polyphenols are very important. And among polyphenol, phenolic acids, flavonoids, and other phenol occupy a predominant position. Now let us see the examples of functional components. These are the first column consists of the phytochemicals. The second column is the source, food source, and third column, the beneficial effect of these foods or these phytochemicals on our human body. For example, beta-carotene. This beta-carotene is present in carrots and various orange, yellow-colored fruits and vegetables. These beta-carotene, it bolsters cellular antioxidant defenses. Lycopene. Lycopene is a red color pigment, and this is present in tomatoes and processed tomato products. This lycopene helps in the maintenance of prostate health and in the prevention of prostate cancer. Next, coming to dietary fiber. Dietary fiber is of many types. Among them, beta-glucan, cellulose and mucilages, gums are important. Beta-glucan is present in oats and its byproducts. Cellulase and mucilages, they are present in wheat bran and husk. Gums and mucilages, they are present in legumes and seed husk. All these dietary products, they help in reducing the risk of coronary heart disease, cancer, and maintain healthy blood glucose levels. Next, coming to saturated fatty acids. Fatty acid may be monounsaturated fatty acid and polyunsaturated fatty acids. The examples, the sources of monounsaturated fatty acids are tree nuts, and they help in the reduction of heart diseases. Polyunsaturated fatty acids, example, walnuts and flax seeds, they help in the maintenance of mental and visual function. Next, coming to flavonoids, anthocyanidins. These anthocyanidins are present in berries, cherries, and red grapes. They provide us immunity and also bolster cellular antioxidant defenses. Flavonoids, examples are catechins, epicatechins, and procyanidins. they are presenting tea, cocoa, chocolate, apple, grapes, and they're helpful in the prevention of heart diseases. Proanthocyanidins, these are present in cranberries, cocoa, apple, peanuts, and cinnamon. They contribute to urinary tract health and a healthy heart. So these are the examples of the phytochemicals, their sources, and their potential benefits. Sulforaphane is a sulfur-containing compound. It is present in the cruciferous vegetable group like cauliflower, broccoli, cabbage, kale, Brussels sprouts, etc. Bolster cellular antioxidant defenses and helps in the prevention of cancer. Since ancient time, the use of plants for their health-promoting property has been common in populations. As phytochemicals are present naturally in plants, they are generally considered safe for consumption without any side effect or toxic effect. Nevertheless, several natural compounds found in various commonly consumed plants could be toxic when consumed in high doses or when it is consumed for a long term. Preclinical, clinical, and epidemiological research suggests that phytochemicals may be effective in treating various diseases owing to their antioxidant and anti-inflammatory activities. On the other hand, consumption of certain phytochemicals may cause some acute and chronic toxic effects, such as development of cancer, liver toxicity, and renal problems. It is obvious that the amount of phytonutrients taken, the individual age and gender, and the condition as well as and the exposure levels are important in the occurrence of potential risk. The daily consumption of specific phytonutrients may easily reach high levels when high doses of related compounds containing dietary supplements are taken simultaneously. Consumers need to know the right phytonutrient dosage they should take in either foods or dietary supplements. Consequently, the safety assessment of phytopharmaceutical preparation should be very well established before use. So, which looks more appetizing? I suggest this Nutri Bars. Thank you for listening.